Now we will start with first method, that is shunt capacitor compensation. Shunt capacitor compensation means here I am dividing this one with two parts. First part is case 1 without shunt capacitor. Without shunt capacitor means initially I have only the generator which is connected to the load through the transmission line like this. See here. See the load. Load is operating at a power factor of cos phi 1. Okay. And this is the reactive power demand of the load. And this is Q1. Q2 is the reactive power which is supplied by the generator. And this is sending end voltage. This is the receiving end voltage. So this is the net reactive power at the bus. Okay. See here. We will explain this method with one example. If suppose load demand is 10 units. If the load is asking only 10 units. 10 units of reactive power. But generator has to supply only the 8 units. But generator has ability to supply only 8 units. Okay. So the load is, here the load is operating at, here the load is operating at a Q1 which is, rating of Q1 is 10 and is operating at a phase angle of phi 1 having reactive power rating PR, right? It's a PR. It is apparent power. Okay? But the generator is sending only amount of Q2, which is only 8 units. Who will supply this amount, remaining amount of reactive power? See here. Case 2. If I add the shunt capacitor across the load, see here, this is with shunt capacitor. Suppose if I add the shunt capacitor across the load is CSH. Shunt capacitor, since the capacitor has the ability to deliver the amount of lagging VARs, it has to supply remaining amount of reactive power, that is remaining 2 units has to supplied by the capacitor. And as we know, generator is asking sending only 8 units. But the load is asking 10 units. The total reactive power of the load demand is compensated. Right? So by adding a shunt capacitor across the load, shunt capacitor has the ability to deliver the amount of reactive power to the load. Right? So the remaining amount of 2 units, remaining amount of 2 units can be compensated by adding shunt capacitor. Now see here. Here. Initially, the load is operating at Q1 at a power factor of phi 1. Okay. Now, if I compensate this amount of reactive power, if I compensate this amount of reactive power by QSH, this is Q2. This amount of Q2 is supplied by generator. This QCSH is supplied by the capacitor, right? capacitor. Now the load is operating at a phase angle of phi 2. Okay? So the load is operating at a power factor of cos phi 2. Now tell me here, by compensating this amount of reactive power, the phase angle is decreases from phi 1 to phi 2 such that power factor can be improved or not. So the shunt capacitor is mainly used for improving the power factor. Okay? So by compensating the amount of reactive power required by the load, okay, the phase angle is decreases from phi 1 to phi 2 such that the shunt capacitor has to improve the power factor, right? So the shunt capacitor mainly used to improve the power factor. So if I want to find out the rating of the shunt capacitor and capacitance required for compensating this reactive power, I want to do the derivation. Now see here, since the shunt capacitor is compensating this amount of reactive power QCSH, but Q1 is topmost, right? The reactive power rating of the shunt capacitor, that is rating of the shunt capacitor is equal to QCSH is equal to what? It is load demand minus reactive power which is supplied by generator, because here the load demand is more, that is Q1 minus Q2. Okay? Suppose it is the active power, this is apparent power, yes? Now tell me, what is Q1 in terms of phi 1? We already know Q is what? Vi sin phi. Okay? If I multiply with cos phi and divide with cos phi, it is Vi cos phi means P into sin phi by cos phi means tan phi. Okay? So that is equal to, what is Q1 is equal to, active power is constant, there is no change in the active power demand of the load, only the reactive power demand of the load has to be changes by compensating the reactive power. Okay? So P into tan phi 1 from bigger triangle, tan phi 1 is P in, tan phi 1 is P Q by P. Okay? Similarly, it is minus P into tan phi 2. That is equal to P into tan phi 1 minus tan phi 2. This is the rating of the shunt capacitor required to compensate VR is less than VS, right? So this mainly the shunt capacitor is used to compensate this only VR is less than VS, and also to improve the power factor of the system. These two are very, very important. Be remembered. So the rating of shunt capacitor has to determined in VARs or KVARs or MVARs, depending upon rating of the this capacitor bank. Okay? Now I want to find out the capacitance in farads required to compensate or to supply the amount of reactive power to the load. So see here, where P means it is three phase active power input to the load. and QCSH, it is a three phase reactive power rating of shunt capacitor, right? These two are three phase powers. Okay, so if I want to find out reactive power rating of per phase reactive power rating of shunt capacitor is given by, it is P into tan phi 1 minus tan phi 2 by 3. Take it as equation 1. So, I want to know about practical arrangement of shunt capacitor at substations. Practical arrangement of shunt capacitor at the substations. See here. See here, this is a practical arrangement of shunt capacitors, shunt capacitor bank at the substations. This is called as three-phase capacitor bank. These are called cells, capacitance cells. These are connected in each and every cell in series. Okay? See here, this is the reactive power which is supplied by the capacitor bank, and this is the reactive power demand of the load, and this is the reactive power which is supplied by the generator. Suppose if the load demand is increases suddenly, what happens? We will switch this capacitor bank, so capacitor has ability to deliver the lagging VARs. Then by switching the shunt capacitor, the amount of reactive power required by the load can be compensated by this shunt capacitor bank. Okay, so if I want to find out the capacitance per phase required, this value, suppose this is the capacitance per phase required, I want to find out the capacitance required per phase for supplying this amount of reactive power compensation. So in case of pure capacitor, so rating of capacitor is equal to, we already know Q is equal to Vi sin phi. So for pure capacitor, phi is what? 90 degrees. So reactive power is equal to V into I into sin 90, it is V into I. So it is, suppose it is per phase reactive power rating, it is V phase into I phase. Okay, that is equal to per phase rating of reactive power rating is equal to V phase into I phase, means V phase by Xe. So what is Xe? V phase into V phase by, it is 1 by 2 pi F into C phase, right? That is equal to V phase square into 2 pi F into C phase. This is the per phase rating of the reactive, this shunt capacitor. The per phase rating of the shunt capacitor. So see here, take it as equation 2. Previously we have derived the formula QC per phase equal to P into tan phi 1 minus tan phi 2 by 3. So equation 1 and 2 will represent the same. So equate equation 1 and equation 2, then you will get V phase square into 2 pi F into C phase is equal to what? P into tan phi 1 minus tan phi 2. So the capacitance per phase required to compensate the reactive power required by the load is equal to P into tan phi 1 minus tan phi 2 by 2 pi F into V phase square. So here phi 1 is the power factor angle of the load, without shunt capacitor, right? Now phi 2 is the power factor angle of the load with shunt capacitor. So by adding a shunt capacitor across the load, additional amount of reactive power required by the load is compensated by delivering the amount of reactive power. This is QCSH by the shunt capacitor. Then the power factor of the system can be improved, and also we can compensate the VRE less than VS. We also compensate this value to VR is equal to VS. Okay, this is the value of capacitance required by the shunt capacitor. This is very, very important according to the solving gate problems. Next, we'll go for the next compensation technique, that is shunt reactor compensation method. Shunt reactor compensation. This also comes under receiving and control side. Where we are using shunt reactor compensation? If I want to compensate VR is greater than VS, that is, if I want to compensate the Ferranti effect, I am using shunt reactor. Okay? So, whenever the load demand is less, whenever load demand is less, we are using shunt reactor compensation. Okay? Now, we will see. We will also discuss this one with two cases. Okay? Case 1. Without shunt reactor. Okay, this is shunt reactor. And see here. So, here I have the generator which is connected to the load through the transmission line. Here, this is Q2, which is reactive power which is supplied by the generator, and Q1 is the reactive power demand of the load, and this is the net reactive power at the receiving end side. If suppose this is the sending end voltage, this is the receiving end voltage. Suppose the load is operating at a power factor of cos phi 1. See here, we will explain this one with some example. If the reactive power demand of the load is only 8 units, but generator has ability to supply 10 units, the net reactive power means what? 10 minus 8, that is 2. Who will consume the remaining reactive power which is supplied by generator? That is shunt reactor only. Now, see here. In this case, initially the load is operating at Q1 at a power factor angle of phi 1. Okay, this is the active power demand of the load, this is apparent power. But Q2 is what? Set where? Somewhere. Okay, now see here, case 2, with shunt reactor. Which shunt reactor means, see here, if suppose if I add the shunt reactor across the load, this is LSH, that is shunt reactor, and this is the reactive power demand of the load, and this is the reactive power which is supplied by the generator, and this is the net reactive power. Okay, see here, since the generator is supplying more reactive power, that is 10 units, but the load is asking only the 8 units, the remaining 2 units can be consumed by this shunt reactor. Okay, so now see here, that is equal to, see, initially the load is operating at Q1. Surely the load is operating at Q1 at a power factor angle of phi 1. So the load demand is, the reactive power supplied by the generator is Q2. So by consuming the amount of additional reactive power by the shunt reactor, the power factor angle is increases from phi 1 to phi 2. Now what happens in this case? phase angle is increases from phi 1 to phi 2, where phi 2 is greater than phi 1, that is cos phi 2 is less than cos phi 1. Now what happens here? The shunt reactor is not improving the power factor. It only compensating the Ferranti effect only. See here. By adding shunt reactor will consume the additional amount of reactive power which is supplied by the generator except by the load. Okay? So it will consume the additional amount of reactive power. Then it will make VR is equal to VS. Then what is the meaning of this making VR is equal to VS? It is compensating the Ferranti effect only. So by consuming the amount of reactive power, additional amount of reactive power, the phase angle is increases from phi 1 to phi 2. So the shunt reactor will change the power factor from leading to lagging. So it cannot improve the power factor of the system. It's very, very important. The shunt reactor cannot improve the power factor. It will only compensate the Ferranti effect, that is VR, which is greater than VS. Okay. Now I want to find out the rating of shunt reactor required, and also I want to find out the per phase inductance required to compensate this reactive power. See here, so the reactive power which is compensated by this reactor is equal to what? Rating of shunt reactor is equal to QLSH is what? It is Q2 minus Q1. Previously it is Q1 minus Q2. Okay. It is Q2 minus Q1. That is what? Q2 means what? Q2 is related to phi 2. That is P into tan phi 2 minus P into tan phi 1. That is equal to P into tan phi 2 minus tan phi 1. This is the rating of shunt reactor required for compensating the amount of reactive power. Okay? So, where is P here? P is equal to 3 phase active power to power input to the load. It is under the units for active power. Kilowatts or watts or megawatts. Okay. And also here QLSH is the three phase reactive power rating of shunt reactor. Okay. Now I want to find out the per phase rating of the shunt reactor. So, what is per phase rating? So, QLSH per phase is equal to P into tan phi 2 minus tan phi 1 by 3. What is phi 2 here? Phi 2 is power factor angle. Angle with shunt reactor, and phi 1 is power factor angle without shunt reactor. Okay. Now I want to find out inductance per phase required for the shunt reactor for compensating this QLSH. Okay. So, take this as equation 1. Equation 1. Now, we already know reactive power consumed by the reactor is equal to what? Q phase is equal to V phase I phase sine phi. So for pure inductor or reactor, phase angle phi is 90 degrees. So per phase rating of shunt reactor or shunt inductor is equal to V phase into I phase. Okay? So that is equal to V phase into V phase by XL. XL is a capacitive reactance. Okay? That is equal to V phase square by what is XL? 2 pi FL. So reactive power rating of per phase reactive power rating of shunt reactor is equal to V phase square by 2 pi FL. Take it as equation 2. Since equation 1 and 2 will represent the same, equate 1 and 2. Okay? By equating 1 and 2, then you will get P into tan phi 2 minus tan phi 1 by 3 is equal to V phase square by 2 pi FL. Okay? Now this is per phase inductance L phase, and to find out the per phase inductance required by the shunt capacitor, shunt reactor. So per phase inductance is equal to what? It is 3 V phase square by P into tan phi 2 minus tan phi 1 into 2 pi F. This is a formula for per phase inductance required to compensate the amount of reactive power for compensating the Ferranti effect, that is VR is greater than VS. Okay? This formula is also very important according to problems. Okay? Next, I want to know the relation between Q and frequency and voltage in case of capacitance compensation and reactor compensation. Okay? Relation between QC, V and F in case of capacitance. QC means reactive power compensated by the capacitor. So we already know QC per phase is equal to 2 pi F V phase square into C phase, since QC is proportional to V square into F. So Q2 by Q1 is equal to V2 by V1 whole square into F2 by F1. And similarly, in case of inductor, I want to know the relation between QL, V and F. Okay? So we already know per phase rating of the reactive power, per phase rating of the shunt reactor is equal to V phase square by 2 pi F into L phase. That is what? Q is L proportional to V square by F. So in this case, Q2 by Q1 is equal to V2 by V1 whole square into F1 by F2. These two formulas are very, very important. Okay?